In learning the basics of graphic design, it is super important to avoid these 3 points to make professional looking designs every single time. Now, the reason I like to give you graphic design advice is because the better you are at design, the more likely you are of a chance of getting clients. And I have seen these mistakes come up way too often and I don't want you to be making them, so here we go. The first mistake to avoid is don't put your type right up against the edge of the page. It is really important that you have room for your designs to breathe. Part of a good design is not just what's on the page, but what is not on the page. If you see this design here, doesn't it make you tense up or feel like something's just not right? How about when you see this one here? Do you feel more likely to read what's on the page? White space gives importance to what it is around. So to practice proper layout, when I first started, I would put blocks of random text on a page and blocks of gray boxes. You can sketch this out or you can actually do it in a document on the computer. This helped me to see what looked good together and what didn't on more of a broader scale. And you just practice this over and over and over until you can really see what a good layout is and what isn't. The second is having too many color choices. I have a recurring client who loves to make me use tons of different colors because that's what she says her clients love. And every time I do a design for her, I kind of cringe because you really want to make sure that the colors of your design are harmonious. Now, this one is a bad example of using too many colors. And here is a great example of using color harmony. Now, a great source when you're just starting understanding colors is to look at nature and pick different color harmonies from a picture that you find. Additionally, something you want to avoid is when you use colors that are very similar in tone, meaning the lightness or darkness of that color. When you use them on top of each other, it can become very hard on the eye when they appear that way and people won't be able to actually read what's there and it'll kind of clash. Instead, use something that's easier on the eye so that there is a contrast between the type and the background. Okay, the third thing to avoid is not having legible type or using too many fonts. The purpose of a design is to attract the viewer to read what you're creating. So sacrificing legibility for a pretty design is a huge mistake. And having too many fonts in a design is distracting and just looks amateur. So when you instead put together the design with the purpose of attracting the ideal viewer in an aesthetic way, you're gonna achieve a better design that way. Okay, as with any design rule, there are exceptions, but it is always best to master the rule before breaking it. So if this video was helpful to you, please hit that like button. And if you are looking to get more clients, check out my free guide to double your own design clients in the description below. Thanks for sticking to the end of the video. And for more helpful graphic design tips to improve your skills or to set up your design business correctly, definitely check out these other videos here. And I will see you next time.